Hey everyone, welcome to day 15 of the 15-day songwriting challenge. Congratulations on making it to the end of this challenge. I know there's a lot of information in these videos and you guys really had to do a lot of work to write your song. So congratulations on sticking with it and making it to the very end. Today we're gonna be talking about the finishing touches for your song and the next steps that you can take for your songwriting journey. So be sure to download the free template below. And if you're on Patreon, then you can actually download the full complete songwriting book of all the pages from this challenge. So for the finishing touches of your song, I recommend making a recording and listening back to it. I find that listening to the song is a different experience from playing the song, so you might notice some different things when you actually sit down to listen to it. Maybe you're gonna hear some syllables sticking out in a weird way, or maybe the rhyme scheme isn't working all the time, or maybe some melody notes are a little bit strange. So just sit down, actually listen to the song, and see if there are any tweaks and adjustments that you still want to make for the final version. Then next, I recommend playing your song for a family member or for a friend and ask them for their feedback. You may or may not like their feedback, but it's always good to get a second opinion. And if you don't like the feedback, then you just don't have to use it. But do it now while the song is still fresh, because oftentimes if you let a song sit for a long time, you're not gonna wanna change it later. And even if someone gives you good feedback, you're still probably not gonna wanna change it because all the pieces after a while kinda get locked in and the song becomes less moldable. So then what happens is someone gives you some good advice, but you don't really want to change it, and then every time you play the song after that, you're like, oh, I should change this part, but I don't know how anymore. So do it now while the song is fresh so that you can still change things about it. So another thing that might happen when you play the song for somebody else is you might notice some things about the song that still aren't working. So something that happened to me is I shared one of my songs with my friend and he told me, the lyrics in verse 2 aren't really working yet, I think you need to rewrite that part. And I was like, well, I like the lyrics in verse 2, so I'm gonna leave it how it is. And then I played it for another friend and I could see in verse 1 and in the chorus, she was starting to cry. But then when we got to verse 2, the tears went away. So I was like, you know what, maybe my other friend was right and I need to rewrite the second verse so that I can really get those tears to happen. But I wouldn't have realized that if I hadn't played it for my other friend and noticed her reaction to the song. So go be brave, play it for somebody and see what happens. Then you might also be wondering how to know when your song is done. So I heard this great quote about writing one time, that the writing is done when you can see the mistakes, but you don't know how to fix them. And I think that can be applied to songwriting as well. And then the other thing is, I think that it's also just kind of a feeling that if you feel like it's done, then it probably is done. So if you want to continue your studying of songwriting, what I recommend is just listening to great songs and then analyzing them for yourself. So taking a look at what you think is great about the song and then trying to figure out what the songwriter did to make it great. So you can look at the lyrics, look at their rhyme schemes, look at their chord progressions, and look at the melodies, try to figure out what's so good about the song. And then another thing that you can do is listen to great songwriters talk about their processes for writing songs. You'll really learn a lot by listening to them talk about it. So I'll leave some good books down below as well as some podcasts and YouTube videos that you can look at if you're interested. And then my last little piece of advice is I would urge you to make a final recording of the song as well as a final draft of the lyrics and the chords. Write them down somewhere so that you have a complete version. You're gonna be really glad that you did this later on because this is kind of a little snapshot of your life, and every time that you listen to the song or play it again, it's gonna take you back to this moment. And last of all, we're gonna be having an open mic over on Patreon where everyone can share their new songs. So come join us over there if you're interested in that. It'll be at the end of this month. So that is everything. Thank you so much for joining me on this songwriting journey. I hope that you learned something. I hope that you enjoyed the process. And I hope that you wrote a song that you're very proud of. Thank you so much for being a part of this. And I will see you in the next video. Have a lovely day. Bye.